day I was asked to go, in 1979, I was asked to go to Washington, to the State Department. They were having a Liberators Conference, and they chose two liberators from each state, and two from each country in Europe, even behind the Iron Curtain, so that they would have witnesses, and we all gave testimonials at this Liberators Conference in Washington. And I was only in Washington an hour when it hit me, and I was standing in the lobby of this little hotel we were staying at, and this was not a Jewish gathering. These were just liberators chosen at random, maybe less than 10% of us were Jews. And I was standing in a circle in the lobby of this hotel, and I thought I heard myself talking, because these men started to say, you know, it didn't hit me for 15 or 20 years. And then all of a sudden, I could see all the dead bodies, and I could smell them, and I could see, I started to dream about them, and I had to go into therapy. And I stood there on the periphery of the group, and I said, my God, I'm talking. And it wasn't me, it was everybody felt the same way. And we were hypnotized. And you asked me before, what did you feel like when you went into the camps? I felt nothing. And when I was 35, I felt it all. And it hit, boom. And from then on, I just went berserk. I sat in that conference, and there was a man sitting next to me who was the principal of a high school in Boise, Idaho. And for 3 days, I held that man in my arms because he was sobbing. He wasn't as strong as I was. And I found out that everybody cries. And it's not a shame to cry. It's a human feeling.